Hello everyone, welcome back to Painting with the Artist, brought to you by the Will Wright Museum of the American Indian. I'm your host, Dillen Peace, and we're going to continue this painting of these very beautiful geraniums we had going on. Last thing I did was laying out the flowers a little bit. I think I like where they're sitting. You know, kind of had this kind of triangular configuration, which I think keeps your eye in the center of the work. You know, kind of will. That's what I like to pay attention to, is, you know, how are my eyes moving around the composition. I think right now what we're going to do is we have this surface that all of the jars are sitting on, and we have to get the white of this little wall sitting up there. So it's not really white, it's kind of like a off-white cream color. So I'm gonna mix something. Too much color to go over everything we've already done, and so I'll keep this fairly thin. And often what I like to do is, you know, it might be a little bit too hot, but it's fine. What I often like to do kind of helps me out is, just looking a little bit bare, you know, with this white of the gesso. So I'm just looking at this nice cream color. It's using a very small brush, which I might not be the best idea. Yeah.
hard edges. It just doesn't look natural.
Okay, I think that looks a lot better. So
what I'm noticing now, I take
a step back and noticing I could, define the actual plants a little bit more.
So I'm going to go back into my green.
I'm still not being very precise, you know. I see some part of a leaf here and part of a leaf there, and just kind of just putting it about where it
looks like. I don't think
you really need to be worried about getting the right shape, the right color, the right
anything.
It's important that you know that you're creating something entirely new, even if you have a reference, even if you're painting something specific, someone specific, ultimately you're still creating something. And so I think it's really important to allow it to come into its own sort of meaning, you know. It doesn't need to be, can never really be an exact copy or an exact presentation. It's always going to be painting, so I think it's important to just know you're making a painting. Give it that freedom to become its own thing. And that's why also, I mentioned before that I think it's important to also, everybody has a practice, or everybody has their own process, but I think it's important that you kind of have certain things that you do, but certain things you allow yourself to vary, make different decisions for different paintings. Each painting is its own thing. And that's why I also like to vary my subject matter a lot. I can paint flowers, or do a portrait of someone, do a landscape. What I really need in my work is to keep things fresh and to kind of respond to different things. And you're always going to be building upon things you already know. For example, how I treat this glass, or how I treat these leaves, I can take into any of the work I do after this. Kind of understand, how I did that, what worked, what didn't, and what can change. But also, you're kind of, as you paint different things or draw different things, you're just really building your visual vocabulary. So I just try to keep that in mind, not define, you will, your eyes will return to what isn't very defined. Right now, it looks like these glass jars again. And so, I think I'll take a little bit more, a little bit stronger, like blue, less white. It's not only in my mind, are you seeing through the glass? Are you seeing the light that's reflected? Some more dark green in these leaves, or light green, maybe dark green for now. And then see how it looks. So I'm just gonna add some brown and some purple to my green. Shape shadows and eye lights into place as sunlight changes. If you're painting with sunlight, then obviously all of the light is going to change as well. I think responding to the light and the change in light will, it certainly adds a sure that there's a dimension to your work, to what you're painting. So there's a leaf. Maybe that's what it is, but I'm gonna add another one here. And so really what I'm really doing is I'm just kind of, I guess you could say I'm just choosing which parts I want to keep, which parts I don't. Depending on what fits best in the painting. Some dark on this side. So again, it's important to take a step back every now and then, kind of look at what is going on. For example, I can see some of these darks that I added up here. I could use the same thing down here. So I'm just going to do that a little bit. And if you don't have a lot of space to step back from your work, especially if you're working on something a lot larger than this, if you want to get a better perspective of the piece as a whole, what you can also do is just take a step back and take a picture of your work so far, and then you'll look at it differently. Picture it on your phone than you would up close, and you can kind of see things that you wouldn't otherwise. Step back. But I'm
this point, I might start thinking everything is looking that it's fairly in place or in a good composition. And so what I'll start doing is putting a little bit more thicker paint on, a little bit more medium with it. For now,
thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next episode.